Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to show you a holster I got for my Smith & Wesson Model 327 Pugnose. Before I go on, just a really quick update. This revolver is working out extremely well. I still shoot it religiously. Well, actually, the last few weeks I have not. But anyways, I do shoot mainly .38 specials out of this. And the defensive ammo that I use at the range would be the Spear Gold Dot 357 Magnum 135 grain short barrel. And that works out extremely well with this revolver. So I would highly suggest that loading for any snub-nosed revolver out there. I have shot some 130 grain HydroShock Magnums out of this, which I didn't really like. But I no longer shoot critical defense, critical duty Magnums out of this thing. So it's basically the Gold Dots. Alright, so let's kind of talk about this holster here. It's an inside-the-waistband holster coming to you from Lobo Gun Leather again. So let's just take a look at this. Model inside-the-waistband. Fits Smith & Wesson N-2-inch, that's an N-frame 2-inch. And the options that I asked for are the hammer shield, and I wanted it made in horse hide, because it's going to be stuffed in the pants, and the hot and humid summer months are here, right? So there's certain times where I want to use an inside-the-waistband holster, because I'm wearing maybe a shorter type of t-shirt, you know, where I'm going. Requires, you know, I'm not wearing as bulky clothing, I guess. So inside the waistband, that's my thought and why I got this. Now, Lobo Gun Leather has about a 2-month lead time, so you're going to be waiting at least 8 weeks to get one of his holsters. This one took about 2 months to get. So let's just check it out. I got it in a different color just for the hell of it. And I think it's Cordovan, maybe. It's kind of like a really dark brown like that. No one's going to see this holster, but hey, I just wanted something a little different. Kind of reminds me of the Ultimate VersaMax 2 made by Milt Sparks. Same type of concept and design, I guess. But this is made for an N-frame revolver. So, guys, literally, I just want to show you this other holster right here made by Lobo. I did a video about this a little while ago. And literally, I wear this holster every single day, 7 days a week. Not all the time, you know, not all throughout the day, but at some point of the day, I'm wearing this gun on me. So this holster here is somewhat of a testament to this guy's quality. All right, it still looks new. I don't know how many presentations I've done from this holster. I wear it every single day, all right? The only thing I noticed was the leather is cracking on these belt slots right here. But I do not feel that that's any big deal because it's thick leather, but I just want to point that out. It's starting to crack there. And on this side, it's cracking here. Okay, again, not that big of a deal because it's pretty thick leather. It's not just going to break right through. I have full confidence in this type of holster. It conceals extremely well for an outside-the-waistband holster, and that's because of its short little barrel on this Pugnose. So when this is on me, on my person, my t-shirt rides way lower than this barrel right here, and this thing hugs right to my body. So I will say this holster, the outside of the waistband, it's called Enhanced Pancake, works out extremely well for me. And like I said, I wear this gun every single day. Not all the time throughout the day, but it's on me at some point in the day. Trust me. So this holster here is definitely working out very, very well. I love it. I really do. Now, on the inside of the waistband holster like this here, it's made for the 1.5-inch belt. And, you know, in my usual fashion, I'll quickly show you what it looks like on my person. So this is horse hide. It definitely has a distinctive scent. It's a little bit different. But I did notice that it's all cracked right here. Now, granted, this is just cosmetic. But see that? It's like all cracked up here. It's cracked up here. Again, not a big deal unless it starts flaking off for some reason. But I just wanted to point that out. So what do I think about this inside the waistband holster? I like how it looks, even though no one's going to see it. I like the color. I think the stitching, you know, using that type of stitching, this color stitch here is pretty cool. It just makes it give it that little, I don't know, cool look, I guess. But when I put this in here, right, I did have a little bit of an issue with the cylinder hanging up on the side of the holster like that, especially when the holster is on me. So what I have to do is come in like this, twist, and then push it in, and it goes right in. This one didn't require much of a break-in for some reason. I guess, I don't know. It was kind of broken in already, but this is what it looks like. So this is an inside-the-waistband holster. The horse hide seems to be thinner than the cowhide. It's supposedly supposed to repel sweat a little better, so we'll see if that works out. But the one thing I want to say, no fault of the holster's design, is this holster can become pretty intolerable, unwearable, if you do not have this in the sweet spot. Again, nothing of fault of the actual design. It's the revolver. This is a end frame, which is, you know, not that big of a deal, 8-shot cylinder. So it's a very, very fat cylinder. So what is going on? If this is not in the sweet spot, this part of the holster right here, where it sticks up, is pressing right into the body. And it's extremely annoying. So, like I said, no fault of the holster design, but it's this fat cylinder. It's an 8-shot cylinder. So that's what's creating the trouble. So I got to get in the sweet spot. Even in the sweet spot, you still feel this part of that holster just pressing right up against your body. But there are times where I'm going to have to just deal with it, because there are times where I need to carry inside the waistband. Not all the time. This works out very well right now for me. So I mainly carry in this, in his enhanced pancake, which works A+. This one here, it's annoying with that cylinder coming out right there. And as you can see, it's a little bit worn right there from my body, I guess. I don't know. That wasn't there originally. Starting to wear out, or the dye is coming off right in there, because it's pressed up right on my body moving around, but it just comes out a lot. The other thing I'm looking for, again, for another holster for my pug nose, which I don't need right away, is probably a paddle holster. That might be next, because I need to be able to take off the gun on and off, not frequently, but I may have to come fall. So that's why I'm looking at a maybe a really nice paddle holster. So stay tuned on that in the saga of carrying this 327 2-inch. It's working out very well. All right, guys, let me show you what this gun looks like on my person. All right, let's go. All right, so let's check out what this holster looks like on my person. As you can see, it's right inside the waistband. I do want to mention that a few times where I did, I guess, violently reholster my pug nose into this inside the waistband holster here, the belt loop button snap came undone. So I just want to point that out there. It's really not that big of a deal, but it did come undone when I was shoving it back in. But as you can see, I'm wearing a shorter type of t-shirt, shorter garment, because sometimes I'm going to be wearing a shorter t-shirt. So that's why I wanted to get it inside the waistband holster like this, to be able to cover just the top part grip. Now it is in the sweet spot, but I still feel that cylinder pressing right up against my body. So certain times where certain movements, I really feel it. Other times it's okay. But when you have your belt ratcheted down, you know, it really pulls it in, and basically you can feel that eight round cylinder. Now you do need a good gun belt. This one right here is my old school Milt Sparks belt that I've owned since 2002. So that's a testament to Milt Sparks. But I do have a Comptac belt that I should probably do a video on that. That's a really good belt. But again, you need a good gun belt. My Zax leather gun belt, it just does not fit either of these Lobo belt loops, these or especially the enhanced pancake. It just won't go through. That's too bad, because I really like that belt. So here you go. This is what it looks like. I'll just do one presentation because the shirt's all tucked in, but I want to show you what it looks like concealed underneath the t-shirt. But that it hugs right up against the body, as you can see. So comes right out smooth, reholstering, you know, goes right back in. But let's see if we can just conceal it like this, all right, and see what it looks like under a shorter shirt. As you can see, it conceals not too bad. You might be able to see that grip, but it's not too bad right there. So if you want to pull it out, it comes right out. So overall, I think it is a pretty good holster. Depending on your body shape, it might just press up in the wrong spots, and it might be a huge annoyance to you. So I just want to throw that out there, 8-shot cylinder especially. But if you have a Glock 19, especially a 1911 that's nice and flat, this is going to work out very, very well. But I just want to throw it out there, 8-shot cylinder is pretty fat, so it's up to you. All right, guys, that's about it. So as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.